Hi everybody. Something that people struggled with in the last unit was calculating volumes, specifically small volumes like the volume of a human cell. So, like I mentioned in my last video, cells always come in strange shapes, but you want to turn that into something more manageable, something that you're familiar with and that's easy to calculate because after all, this class is all about estimation. So I recommended turning it into some sort of cubic shape. Something that has a width, length, and height, where you can calculate the volume and not get too confused. And some people got stumped right off the bat on, well, I don't even know where to begin with how big a cell is. Well, that's where in this class you have to go online or look up in a book how big, at least a ballpark number for how big a human cell is. So a number that kept coming up when I did my search for this size was about 10 microns. 10 microns or micrometers. And 1 micrometer is equal to 1 millionth of a meter. So there's a couple ways that you can calculate this. One way is to take your cubic shape, and you could just call each side 10 microns long. So this is 10, this is 10, this is 10. So 10 times 10 times 10, and this adds up, so 10 times 10 is 100. And 100 times 10 is 1,000. Or you could write this as 1 e, oops, almost lost my book, 3 microns. But the question throws you for a loop and it wants you to express your answer in large units of meters cubed. And I'm sorry, this should be microns cubed, because we times microns by microns by microns, so our unit is cubed. So then the question is, how do I turn microns cubed into meters cubed? Well, this is another unit conversion, but it's a little different than the unit conversions that we did previously because it's a volume. So you can, this is the way I like to tackle these problems. Start out with, so we have a 1,000 microns cubed. Started out like a normal unit conversion, so how many microns are in a meter times, and remember we need to get our units of microns on the bottom so that they cancel out. So we have, I'm sorry, we have 1e to the negative 6 meters is equal to 1 micron. Well, you'll notice these aren't units of volume. So next we have to do something a little tricky by cubing this whole side. And so this stays the same, 1,000 microns cubed, but this time we are multiplying it by, so 1 millionth of a meter. So that's 1e to the minus 6. You might have to break out a calculator for this one. So it's easy enough to do on your calculator. You just go, if I can even turn my calculator on, there we go. 1e to the minus 6 to the third power, and you get 1 e to the minus 18. But you can also do that in your head pretty quickly, because since we're doing scientific notation here, it would be like 1 e to the minus 6 times 1 e to the minus 6 times 1 e to the minus 6, which is the same as 10 to the minus 6 times 10 to the minus 6 times 10 to the minus 6. And you can do this in your head pretty easily, because whenever you have the same base with different exponents, you can just take that base, and then it's really minus 6 plus minus 6 plus minus 6 to get your final exponent, which is 6 times 3 is 18. So your calculator in your head, either way you want to do it. So that to the third power is 1e minus 18 meters cubed. So now we have our right units there for our answer, over 1 micron cubed. And hey, now we have microns in the bottom of our fraction here. So we can cancel those out, and we're left with meters cubed. So 1,000 times 10 to the minus 18th power meters cubed.
And so 1,000
is the same as
1E3, remember?
So you just, and that's the same as 10 to the third power. So it's minus
18 plus 3. So that brings us to our final answer
of 1e
to the minus
15.
Sorry, I wrote it like an exponent.
Man, I'm off my game. 1e 15
meters cubed. And that's our correct answer.
Okay, so I want to show you another way to do it, because I hope I didn't totally confuse everybody with that method. But my other method here, let me get my notes handy. So that's the method I usually like to do it, but the other method that you could use would be to first calculate, do your unit conversion first. So I'll go through this one quickly. So you start with a normal, simple unit conversion, where you go, okay, I think one side of a cell is 10 microns.
Okay. And then you say, how many microns are
in a meter? Well,
1 meter is 1 million. Oh, microns. There, got that right. Okay. So right away our
units cancel, and you're left with 10 times 1 meter divided by 1 million.
So we can turn this
into scientific notation to make it easier. So we'll leave 10 where it is. 1 meter, and 1 million is
1E6. So 10 divided by
1 million
gives you,
you can also do this in the calculator.
So you can tell right away that
it's the same situation here, where if you put this in scientific notation to make things easier, it would be
1E1 divided by 1E6.
So what do you guys think it is? Well, if you don't actually know, you could, you know, if you get confused, you can go to the calculator and just do 10.
And then divide that
by
1E6, 1 million. And there you go, 1E to the minus 5. Okay. So we figured out that 10 micrometers
is equal to 10 to the minus 5 meters.
Or 1E minus 5.
And so, meters. And so what you would do then is, now that you've already gone converted from microns to meters, you're already in the units that you need to calculate your answer for. So some people find this easier, because then
when you have your cubic cell shape, you can just do 1e minus 5 meters,
1e minus 5 meters, and 1e minus 5. And so that's just
1e minus 5 times 1e
minus 5 times 1 e minus 5 meters.
And you get your final answer when you multiply all those together. Remember, they're exponents of the
same base. So we can just add those together. So minus 5 plus minus 5 plus minus 5.
Another way to write this is
10 to the minus 5 times 10 to the minus 5 times
10 to the minus 5.
So then you'd have 10 minus 5 plus minus 5 plus
minus 5, which equals
10 to the minus 15 meters. Or you could write it as 1 e to the minus 15 meters. And that answer looks familiar, doesn't it?
Because we got the exact same answer using the other method.